So I lend you this money, I'm not giving it to you, I'm lending it to you, but make something out of it. And that's the way microfinance works. Yeah. You can't spend it on consumption. You have to come up with a small business.
Yeah, oo. Pero maganda yun, ano, parang accountability, para bang you have a meeting so that, parang, well, partly hiya. Hiya is important here, no?
Plays a role.
Oo, yeah. Na parang they have to come and then...
Yeah, and if somebody's absent, the whole group actually has their different methodologies now. But say Marianne is absent, then the three of us will actually go to her house later and say, Marianne, why did you not attend? So there's that discipline talaga. So, and it's also cultural because they work together. They bond together, that center.
Yeah, yeah. So kaya pala ng Pinoy to we can take care of each other.
Yeah. That's the word. Well, take care of each other. Why do 3,000 people of our people leave every day? Because they realize that they want to have a better life for themselves and their children. And that's why they leave. They're not leaving because they've given up on the country. They're leaving because they want, they need to provide for their families.
Yeah.
And they're willing to go through hell.
Yeah.
They're willing to go through exploitation, humiliation, discrimination, and abuse because they love their families. And they've been doing this for decades. In other words, our people are resilient, are persevering, are hardworking, are willing to sacrifice for their loved ones and their families. But if they have to do this abroad, I'm sure if the opportunity is given to them here, they will also be willing to sacrifice, to persevere, to suffer here. That's the challenge. Well, I'm from government, and that's the challenge of for the government, to provide, to help provide the environment that will provide the opportunities for our people so that they don't have to go abroad.
Filipinos like to connect. Parang you want to belong to that group na ano, di ba? It's the same thing that we like to be in Facebook and Twitter. I mean, we're the national barangay already, di ba? Ganun na tayo mag-isip, di ba? So, ganun yun. I mean, the conversation that we had over the weekend had pati OFW kasama. We had some people from abroad. Actually joined.
Okay.
I mean, that's the whole idea. We think of it, you know, we're a physical family, but a virtual family as well. You know, our culture is, yung ating need to connect, need to belong, need to be with family, plays up to all of that.
Yeah.
And that's why I think that microfinance also succeeds that way.
Yeah, yeah.
And just one more quick point. I believe if our people are inspired, you know, if they are inspired to give their utmost for their families and the country, there is no reason why we cannot succeed.
Okay.
And it is, we have the track record of going through suffering, perseverance, hard work, sacrifice. So if we just are inspired, then our people will step up and deliver.
And we are still inspired now.
Well, inspiration is a continuing thing, you know.
And there's also such a thing as the culture of inspiration, I think.
Meaning?
Which we really have to keep sharing with the Filipinos. I mean, you really have to continue. We have to be a people that can inspire ourselves out of a rut. I mean, nobody's gonna help us, so we have to be the ones.
We have to help ourselves. So you were, I guess, you were all inspired today,
But I think precisely a 25-year horizon. A 25-year horizon creates inspiration for me. I mean, if you begin to imagine the Philippines in 2026, I think that's a source of inspiration.
But we're not just doing mga knee-jerk reactions when a crisis happens. That's what we do, no? Parang side.
However, I was just thinking, and this is coming from a personal perspective that I never really thought about until this moment, but I think we held this conference at a time when that inspiration was available. And I think the Ondoy experience and the Pepin experience actually inspired us. We inspired ourselves. And I think we inspired ourselves more than the elections inspired us. And I think this is a carryover from that moment. I'm beginning to think that we're still carrying that flavor, that mood.
Yeah, it inspired us because that was...
All those elements had no patronage.
Walang patronage
One element in it. It was like people just saying, no, let's do it. It needs to be done. It's the you know, go getter, di ba? Parang ganun type.
Oh, Mark.
You know, just one interesting. The Inquirer wrote about it. 500,000 people decided, the December 31, to go to Luneta for the first time. Nobody told him, well, let's all go there.
Did anybody invite anybody?
There was no big to do, but the people are already saying, I want to do something for myself, I will decide to go there because I want to celebrate the new and the coming of the new year. And boom, 500,000 people are there. People are already doing things, are already moving forward, are already deciding for themselves. Mm-hmm. And this is my take again. Yung leadership, medyo kinakailang maghabol.
Mm-hmm. Oo. Tama yun. Tama, tama.
Nahuhuli pa yung leader.
Ah, talaga?
Well, mm-hmm. well, you know, yeah. leaders are, for me, you know, I have constraints, diba? I have...
Like what?
Well, you know, I have organizations I have to, you know, answer yeah. to, diba? Yeah. And so forth and so on. So but you try your best to not be constrained, diba? Mm-hmm. Not to be, yeah. you know, to break free.
Yeah.
So maybe that's why I'm sort of a maverick of sorts. So I like to
marami ng Pilipinong naka OS na mataas.
OS?
Ang government nasa MS-DOS pa rin.
Ah, okay.
Operating system.
Okay.
Software.
Digital.
Parang kulay green pa yung ano. Okay.
Digital na yung iba, analog pa yung ano. Yung,
Galaxy. Okay, naka-Android okay. na si Jimmy. Yung iba naka-Symbian.
Pero wait a minute. May mga, like Jesse Robredo was there, right?
Yes.
Oh, so how are they reacting? Lalo na pag yung ganung idea came out na medyo nahuhuli ata yung leadership.
He was quite open and I think to the credit of Jesse, he really knows
and
how to, and he's a people person. Eh, no?
mm-hmm. Secretary mm-hmm. Jesse was there, Secretary Hilde Los Reyes of the Grand Reform was also there.
Mm-hmm.
Siddinqui okay. confirmed, but I think because of demands of the office at that time. She
yeah, had you were asked for like workable proposals, no? That was the word, no?
Two what levels. One were practical proposals, and the other level was, well, dream away.
Sige, let's do the practical muna. Okay.
Pero in dream away, I just wanted to qualify. Yeah. These are possibilities that can actually be actionable agenda.
Mm-hmm.
So even if it's a dream away, there is a sense that it can be done.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
For example, somebody said, and he's an indigenous people representative,
oh.
and he says, at the end of 25 years, I want to drink Pasig River water.
Oh.
Okay. It's a dream, but it's not as though it's a pie in the sky.
That's pretty concrete, diba?
Yeah, because ngayon pa lang hindi. Okay.
Pwede namang gawin yun eh. Kung merong...
Well, they did it in Singapore.
Yeah.
I think a decade and a half they were able to bring back.
The same.
Yeah. Well, dreaming because you make it the objective.
In other words,
I mean, it's not just a dream.
It's not just a dream.
Begin with the end in mind, diba?
Yeah.
The end in mind is this.
That's what planning is all about, diba?
Right.
And then you
go back. Yeah.
The science and the money might not be there, but it will be there.
It will be there.
One of the things that came out very, very strongly was a public media, public television sort of.
You talked about.
Lumitaw yun ng napakalakas.
Cross media culture na.
Yes, as a matter of fact, just to get all of the social networking interconnected with some kind of very responsible, very. You know, how media is the de facto Department of Education.
Mm-hmm.
So, rest it back from...
Sige, be a little more direct. Go ahead.
Well, we don't only engage government, we also engage the media.
Yes,
we
yes.
Want, we want media to actually help promote a vibrant Filipino culture.
Yeah.
That sustains and heals its dreams. No?
Yeah. Oh, parang it's like we want to see the Apo Hiking Society on noontime television. No? For someone like you, parang ganon, ano? Wholesome.
Yeah. Well, we wanted media to sort of think that way. I mean, parang personally, I think media is too commercial. It's way too commercial. That, you know, we have to rethink that. I mean, in other countries, you can actually sit through a television, have an evening of television, and really be engaged and be challenged and really feel.
There were journalists and media practitioners there. How did they react to that?
They were in the middle of that.
You know, the way to look at it is, it can be commercially, you know, blockbuster, but at the same time, critically acclaimed.
Right.
I mean, if it can be done that way, then you know, if you can imagine it that way.
No dumbing down, di ba? Mm. No dumbing down on the audience. Wala yung talagang parang very exploitative, you know, so stuff like that.
Because if you already know that the repayment rate of our poor is 99%, then you've got to give some trust and respect for that majority.
Yeah, yeah.
And
right,
that can
right.
be translated into the way you perceive the viewing public.
We might be misreading
the CDE audience,
you know. Now we think that that's what they want. Okay, we'll have to take a short break. Strictly Politics, we'll be right back. Stay with us.